I'm Troy Kirby with Linwood Today with a quick look at the 2021 Washington State legislative session. The House debated Substitute House Bill 1225, which establishes a school-based health center program office within the Department of Health. The bill passed the House 60-36, moving on to the Senate for consideration.
And this legislation brings forward three elements that are critical to the behavioral health needs of our youth. First, Madam Speaker, is the Partner Access Line for Moms. This has been a pilot program, and this legislation makes this a permanent program. The second thing this line does is makes permanent the mental health referral assist line for our teens. The last thing that this legislation does is really move forward a piece of behavioral health work that we need to do for our youngest, our 0 to 5 age group.
I will say that there is some concerns on our side about doing completely from 0 to 5. It would have been, some folks on our side would have preferred to have it 2 to 5. But I think that overall that this is great policy, and I urge your support. Thank you.
I am on second on this with the good lady from District 5. And I too have had questions about it, but I keep reverting back to a history in my life, a 3-year-old that came to live with me. And it was our chance to be able to adopt a little girl that had come from some pretty bad background. And when I would find her almost daily crying in the closet, in a little ball, if I'd had a line to call, somebody to call to start questioning this behavior, that could have saved this little girl's life.
I agree. The PAL line is great. I am just, I'm very, very excited and elated that it's going to become permanent, because it has done a lot of good things for a lot of our families. And I appreciate that. But I'm one of those that had some concerns about this 0 to 5 assessments, a little bit concerned, and that wasn't so much concern in the beginning because I signed on to the bill and I knew what it did. But as I received feedback from different folks from around the state, and as a ranking member on this committee, it seemed like I get most of the negative emails, but I did read them and took my time to read them. And so I'm a little concerned that we went from 0 to 5, that we didn't go from 2 to 5. That's probably my only concern with the bill.
Lawmakers also debated Substitute House Bill 1348, which focuses on medical assistance provided to incarcerated individuals. The bill passed the House 97-0, moving on to the Senate for consideration.
This bill will facilitate immediate access to medical care, including behavioral health treatment and prescription medications for folks who are serving less than 30 days in jail, which is about 90% of our jail population in the state. It also saves money for counties and cities that operate local correctional facilities, because they can actually bill Medicaid instead of bearing the cost for any medical care that's delivered outside of the correctional facility, such as emergency department visits.
This will require a waiver from CMS, and I know that they are actively working on that. I sure hope we get the waiver, because it would sure help these folks coming out from incarceration, get them the things that they need immediately. No gap. They get this, their medications right away. And it does have a benefit to the people, the cities and the counties. So this is a good bill.
Thank you for watching the Daily Legislative Report by Linwood Today, covering the 2021 legislative session.